My work deals with the optimization of chemical processes and mostly in coming up with strategies to automate those decision-making processes for optimization and then to apply them to the operation of chemical plants, the design of new chemical plants, and also looking at how to control them and then finally to take process data, come up with predictive models, and then use those for making better decisions on how to operate and design. Engineers make decisions all the time. They have supporting tools to make decisions, and those are usually predictive models, where they can see the consequences of a decision without actually going out in the field, okay? Now, what we want to do is extend those tools so that instead of just running a case to see the consequence of a particular decision, we can actually make some of those decisions for the engineer in an automatic way. So what we've done over the past 30 years has actually incorporated these optimization decision-making tools within simulation platforms, okay? And we've done this with a number of commercial platforms, and especially now we're working with the Department of Energy to develop a new paradigm, a new framework. Now, optimization has to do with the automation of those decisions and doing them in a way that are efficient, available to that shorten the work process, that are robust and reliable. The challenge is actually to be able to do these things efficiently, come up with ways of handling larger systems, and then also being able to take advantage of finding out how they improve things. It gives us an opportunity of learning about new applications and how they can be improved. And that goes to a variety of things we've looked at, from casting steel, from making wine through fermentations, from looking at ways of creating new polymers in terms of the reaction processes, and also from looking at ways of coming up with cleaner and more energy efficient processes, for example, through carbon capture, through different ways of producing electricity. The challenge we face is basically being able to avoid those errors, finding ways to come up with data-driven models that are accurate, that are not overfit, and that allow us to allow good optimization procedures.